Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. You are all welcome back to the second period for this week. Today, we shall discuss the relationship between power of hydrogen ion and power of hydroxide ion, that is pH and pOH. Remember, in our last class, I gave you the formula for calculating the pH, which says pH is equal to negative logarithm to base 10 of hydrogen ion concentration. We can have the same formula in terms of hydroxide ion concentration. That is, you may have it pOH is equal to negative logarithm to base 10 of hydroxide ion concentration. Now, in order to deduce the formula that connects pH and pOH, we are going to employ, or we start from equation 1. Equation 1, that is ionic product of water. So if you take, or taking the logarithm to base 10 of both sides of this ionic product of water, we are going to have logarithm to base 10 ionic product of water is equal to logarithm to base 10 raised to the power minus 14. According to rule of logarithm, if you have two numbers, multiply each other, and you can easily separate them into different logarithms, in which each of the numbers will have its own logarithm. That is the reason why we have logarithm to base 10 of hydrogen ion concentration plus logarithm to base 10 of hydroxide ion concentration, which is equal to logarithm to base 10 of 10 raised to power minus 14. But from the second formula rather, we said pH is equal to negative logarithm to base 10 of hydrogen ion concentration. You can easily make logarithm to base 10 of hydrogen ion concentration into the subject of the formula by dividing both sides by minus. Now have logarithm to base 10 of hydrogen ion concentration is equal to minus pH. And I also said that we may have pOH is equal to negative logarithm to base 10 of hydroxide ion concentration. By making logarithm to base 10 of hydroxide ion concentration the subject of the formula, we now have it equal to minus pOH. By replacing the logarithm to base 10 of hydrogen ion concentration with pH and logarithm to base 10 of hydroxide ion concentration with pOH, we now have the formula that connects pH and pOH, that says pH plus pOH is equal to 14. This is the third important formula under this topic. We now use this formula for this worked example. The question says, calculate the pH and pOH of a solution whose hydrogen ion concentration is 5.00 multiplied by 10 raised to the minus 4 mole per dm cube. Here, the concentration of hydrogen ion is given directly. It was not given in terms of acid, and it was not given in terms of basic. So the concentration of hydrogen ion is given directly. Here, we first calculate the pH, and pH is equal to negative logarithm to base 10 of hydrogen ion concentration. If you substitute the value of hydrogen ion concentration into the formula, we now arrive at pH is equal to 3.3. So we want to calculate the pOH. So we said pH plus pOH is equal to 14. Just substitute the value of pH and get the value of pOH to be equal to 10.7. Also, let us look at this example 4. This question is very, very important, and the question under this particular topic may come in this form, that you may be asked to calculate hydrogen ion concentration when the pH is given. So here we are given, the question says, What is the hydrogen ion concentration of the solution whose pH is 4.10? Here we were given the value of pH to be 4.10 when the hydrogen ion concentration is to be determined. Now we now apply the formula pH is equal to negative logarithm to base 10 hydrogen ion concentration. If you substitute the value of pH by taking antilogarithm of both sides, we are going to arrive at hydrogen ion concentration equal to 7.94 multiplied by 10 to the minus 5 mole by the n cube. That is the concentration of hydrogen ion that we are required to calculate. Now we now move to pH scale. When we see pH scale, a pH scale is just a scale on pH meter that shows whether a solution is acidic or basic or alkaline solution. So pH scale is a scale of number used to measure the acidity and alkalinity of solution. pH scale therefore ranges from 0 to 14. So this pH scale is just like ruler. You know, if you see ruler, ruler is measured in either centimeter or inches. Likewise, when you have pH meter, there's a scale on pH meter. That is pH scale, which is as the value ranges from 0 to 14. Now, when you have pH scale, if the pH scale read number between 0 to 6, it indicates that that solution is acidic. And when the solution is neutral, the pH scale will read 7. And if the value of the pH scale read between 8 to 14, it means that solution is an alkaline solution or basic solution. Now, as the value of pH decreases, the acidity of the solution increases. That is, the lower the pH scale, the higher the acidity of the solution. When you have pH of 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so that means it indicates acidic solution. But when you have a pH scale of 0, 1, 2, 3, that means the solution is of higher acidity. When you have a solution with pH ranges from 4, 5, 6, that solution is of lower acidity. Now, the higher the pH scale, the higher the alkalinity. It means as the value of pH increases, the alkalinity of solution also increases. When you have a pH scale read a number between 8, 9, 10, that means the solution is of lower alkalinity. But when it reads from 11, 12, 13, 14, it means that solution is of higher alkalinity. The higher the pH scale, the higher the alkalinity of solution. A pH value of 7, a pH scale with value of 7 is a neutral solution. That is, that solution is neither acidic nor basic. For today, we are going to stop here. I want you to take note of the three formula that have been given to you when we start this particular topic. That is, ionic product of water, the second one, the pH equal to the negative logarithm to base 10 of hydrogen ion concentration, and the third one, the formula that connects pH and pOH, which is pH plus pOH is equal to 14. We are going to stop here for today. Inshallah, when we meet next period, we are going to discuss acid-base indicator. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.